Clinicians are in a unique position to identify risk for firearm injury and to reduce that risk, but few talk to their patients about firearm access. So next time you identify a patient at risk, how can you bring up the topic with that person or their caregiver? Here are five things to keep in mind as you approach these conversations. Be informed. Understanding the reasons people own firearms and how to store them safely can help you build rapport with patients who own guns and to make realistic recommendations. Be respectful. Owning firearms can be closely connected with a person's identity or feeling of personal safety. Acknowledging the role firearms play in your patients' lives and respecting their choice to own them can help you have open conversations. Use neutral and non-stigmatizing language. If opinions and politics about firearms come up, redirect the conversation toward health and safety. Focus on risk. Taking a risk-based approach means you don't need to ask every patient about access to guns, just the ones who have risk factors for firearm-related harm, like patients with depression or those living with children. If risk is present, start the conversation by explaining who's at risk, what kind of harm you're concerned about, and why firearm access matters. Practice harm reduction. Your goal is to minimize risk by helping patients take steps, even small ones, towards reducing access to firearms for a person at risk. Every little bit counts. Make individualized recommendations. There is no one-size-fits-all solution, so your job is to make suggestions tailored to each individual patient, the type and level of risk present, and what works for them. For more information, visit bulletpointsproject.org.